What if some of the most advanced technologies of today were actually rediscoveries of ancient knowledge? Could it be that ancient Indian myths weren't just stories, but glimpses of futuristic science? Were our ancestors pioneers of concepts we are only now beginning to understand? Let's separate fact from fiction and explore whether ancient India held knowledge far ahead of its time. Welcome back to Spill Edge. Ancient texts like the Vedas, the Ramayana, and the Mahabharata describe technologies that seem almost magical. Machines that flew through the skies, weapons that behaved like modern missiles, and herbs that could bring the dead back to life. Some of these descriptions seem eerily similar to today's technological advancements. Were these just poetic exaggerations, or could they hint at lost knowledge? In this episode, we'll explore three fascinating examples: the Pushpak Vimana and modern aerospace, ancient Dhanurveda and drone warfare, and the legendary Sanjeevani Booti compared to modern biotechnology. Let's see how the past connects with the present and whether these legends might have had a solid scientific foundation. In the Ramayana, the Pushpak Vimana is a flying chariot used by Ravana and later by Lord Rama. It could travel great distances at high speed, controlled by thought. Sounds impossible, right? But let's take a closer look. Some ancient Sanskrit texts like the Vaimanika Shastra describe flying machines with metallic bodies, propulsion systems, and even pilot training methods. While many historians argue that these descriptions were written in the recent centuries, rather than in Vedic times, the question remains: how did our ancestors even imagine such advanced aerodynamics? Today, we are developing electric and anti-gravity propulsion systems. Scientists are even researching brain-controlled aircraft, technology that eerily mirrors descriptions of the Vimana. Modern stealth aircraft, like India's upcoming AMCA, Advanced Medium Combat Aircraft, use futuristic designs and radar-evading materials, much like the concept of vimanas that could become invisible. Could the stories of ancient flying machines be based on some forgotten principles of aerodynamics? Or were they simply visions of the future written in the past? The Mahabharata describes devastating weapons, brahmastras, which sought out enemies, agniastras, which created firestorms, and vayavyastras, which could control the wind. These descriptions bear an uncanny resemblance to modern missiles, drones, and weather-modifying technology. Dhanurveda, the ancient Indian science of warfare, speaks about specialized combat techniques, long-range weapons, and strategies similar to modern military tactics. In the past, warriors used archery and spears, but today, drones and AI-controlled missiles dominate the battlefield. India's DRDO, Defense Research and Development Organization, is actively working on autonomous weapons and smart defense systems. The Agni and BrahMos missiles, known for their precision and speed, are not very far from the descriptions of celestial weapons that could change course mid-flight. And you've already seen how these BrahMos missiles were used to destroy the Pakistani air bases in the recently concluded Indo-Pak War. Could it be that we are unknowingly following in the footsteps of a forgotten science of war? What do you think? Let me know in the comments. One of the most fascinating legends from the Ramayana is that of the Sanjeevani Booti, a mystical herb that could bring the unconscious back to life. Lord Hanuman carried an entire mountain just to find this rare plant and save Lakshman. While this might sound like pure mythology, modern biotechnology is making incredible advances in healing. Scientists are now experimenting with gene therapy, regenerative medicine, and even cryogenic preservation, methods that could, in a way, bring someone back to life. In Himalayan medicine, researchers have found rare herbs that have extraordinary healing properties, including some that are now being studied for anti-aging, tissue regeneration, and even potential cancer-fighting abilities. Ayurveda, India's ancient medical science, has described several plants with near miraculous effects, some of which are being validated by modern pharmaceutical companies. For instance, ashwagandha and brahmi, known for their brain-boosting properties, are now being examined for their impact on neurological disorders. Could it be that Sanjeevani Booti was an early reference to an undiscovered medicinal breakthrough? Are we finally catching up to the knowledge that was once hidden in ancient scriptures? While we can't say for sure whether these ancient stories describe real technology, they spark curiosity and push us to explore the limits of what's possible. Ancient Indian texts might not be blueprints for future technology, but they encourage scientific thinking. In some cases, ancient wisdom has predicted scientific advancements long before modern discoveries. So, were our ancestors visionaries who imagined the future? Or are we simply following the dreams of the past? Only the future knows. Or if you have answers to these questions, comment them below. That's it for this episode of Tech, Dharma and the Future. If you enjoyed watching this episode, hit that like button. Also, subscribe to Spillage and turn on notifications so you never miss upcoming videos. Stay tuned for the next episode. Until then, take care and see you next time.